Hello students, in this video I'll be introducing you to the topics of unit 4, that is inner product. Let V be a vector space over a field K. If you have two elements U and V in V, if to each U and V in V there is a unique scalar we denote it as UV, then this function is called an inner product if it satisfies the following conditions. The first condition is the linearity property. That is, if you have AU plus BV, the inner product of AU plus BV with W, this should be A times inner product of UW plus B times inner product of VW. The second property is the conjugate symmetry. That is, when you swap the places of U and V, becomes a conjugate. And the third property would be the positive definite property. That is, inner product of U with itself is always greater than or equal to 0. And the equality, that is, we get 0 if and only if we are finding inner product of 0. Now what happens if the field is a real number? So we have the definition of inner product here. Now if I replace field with the set of reals, the field of reals, when V is the vector space over the field of reals, then the first property will not change, that is, linearity will remain the same. This will be in field of reals. In the field of reals, when we say conjugate, the conjugate of a real number is itself. Therefore, the conjugate symmetry property will change to symmetry property. That is, we can interchange the positions of the first and the second element. the third property will remain the same. This is always greater than or equal to 0, and the inner product is 0 if and only if the element is 0. So this would be the definition of inner product for a real vector space. Now the different types of inner products are defined. For example, one kind of inner product we have already seen in R3. That is, if I have vectors A, that is A1, A2, A3, and vectors B, that is B1, B2, B3, inner product of AB, this is A1, B1, plus A2, B2, plus A3, B3. So if you write this in the matrix form, the inner product A equal to A1, A2, A3, B equal to B1, B2, B3, then inner product AB, this is nothing but A transpose B. So the same thing, if I have Rn instead of R3, this would be, if we have UV belongs to Rn, then inner product, so this is the usual or standard inner product, which is the dot product. And it's easy to prove that the three properties hold good, because dot product of AB and dot product of, when we are finding the dot product, the linearity property can be verified. Similarly, interchange of the positions of A and B in finding the inner product will not alter the solution, and dot product of a vector with itself is always a positive number, which is equal to the square of the magnitude of the vector. And you get the inner product equal to 0 only when we are finding the inner product of a 0 vector. Similarly, if I take the set of all functions, the vector space of all continuous functions in the interval a comma b, this is vector space of all continuous functions in defined over the interval AB. Here we can define, so we will have f such that f of x is continuous over AB. So here we can define the inner product of f and g to be integral a to b f of t g of t dt. Therefore, a vector space with a defined inner product is called inner product space. Now we define a norm of a vector. We know that inner product of U with itself is always greater than or equal to 0 because of the positive definite property. So the inner product is always positive if U is a non-zero vector. Therefore, norm of a vector U is denoted as and is given by, this is square root of, positive square root of the inner product. If norm of U is 1, then U is called a unit vector if norm of U not equal to 1, then U by norm U will be a unit vector. The process of obtaining a unit vector is called normalizing of the vector. Suppose V is an inner product space. Now, is a function. Since inner product is a function, norm is also a function. If this function, so if the function norm satisfies the following conditions, that is, norm of U is positive definite, and we get 0 if and only if the vector is 0. The second condition, norm of scalar times U is equal to absolute value of K into norm of U, where K is a scalar in the field and norm of U plus V is always less than or equal to norm of U plus norm of V. If the inner product space with the norm defined as described earlier, if it satisfies these three conditions, then we call V as a normed vector space. Now, every inner product space is a normed vector space. By the properties of inner product, the norm also becomes norm satisfies these three conditions. Therefore, it can be proved that every inner product space is a normed vector space. But suppose so every norm that is defined need not result in inner product space. So every norm on vector space need not result in a inner product space. So I repeat, every inner product space will result in a normed vector space, but every norm that is defined need not result in inner product. For example, if I define the infinity norm, so now infinity norm, which is max of u1, u2, u3, un, or the one norm, which is the sum of absolute values of the components. Now these two form a norm on a vector space. So here I'm talking about, say, Rn. These two definitions form a norm on a vector space Rn, but these will not give us inner products. In the next video, we will see some examples of how to find the inner product and norms for different types of vector spaces, and